Andrew,
yes.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning to talk about Mar Vista and your experience in the town. You've lived there for a few years, I understand.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah, I've been here since the mid-90s. We originally rented a house and then ended up buying a house. And at the time, both of my kids were young. And yeah, so we've been in the neighborhood for quite a while.
Seen any changes?
Unfortunately, yes, I have. I think several years ago, just the homeless situation in and around the Mar Vista community caught my attention. It was hard to avoid. I'm a dog owner. I spend a lot of time walking my dog, and that gave me an opportunity to go around the neighborhood. And, unfortunately, there's just been a steady growth of the homeless population around the neighborhood, the residential area. I live very close to Sawtelle and National, and so there's fairly broad and wide sidewalks, which are very inviting for homeless people to just basically pop up a tent and hang out either behind the Murray Callender's or the Starbucks in the area. You know, there was a point in time where I actually complained to those businesses just because, it was of concern. And the homeless issue first got my attention as a resident of Mar Vista. I reached out. Well, I started a change.org petition about it because I was concerned. And then back in December 2019, that got the attention of council member Mike Bonin. And he invited me to have a quick coffee with him at a Starbucks down on Barrington and National. We did meet. I expressed my concerns. He basically gave me what now it seems to be, with 2020 hindsight, the standard response that we get from a lot of the local representatives and agencies, that there's just limited resources. He kind of put the problem at the feet of the county, saying the county was responsible for services, not the city. And I kind of went away just not really, not satisfied with the response.
Well, it has been a problem, hasn't it? They struck up that relationship. The Lachos is a partnership between the city and the county. I guess it happened while James Hahn was our mayor back in 2001. And I won't belittle people's efforts, but not much to show for it, and a lot of money spent.
Correct. Correct. Like I said, at some point, I think the park, just the encampment at the park just started getting larger and larger. And of course, with that, you get a lot of rubbish and discarded items. I was a little concerned about my dog stepping on something or picking something up. So I would just basically avoid that part of the park. And it got to the point where I just got fed up and said, you know what? Not necessarily that I have the time. I thought it deserved my attention, and I threw my hat into running for a Mar Vista neighborhood council position for my particular zone 3, and on that platform on the homeless issue. And it was quite successful, and we got a landslide as far as I'm concerned, during a time where you had to actually, you couldn't vote in person. You had to ask for a mail-in ballot and provide supporting documentation that you lived in the zone, and then get a mail-in ballot, and then, of course, fill that out and vote. So it was a tough process, yet people overwhelmingly came out and supported me.
Were you surprised to hear of the level of, we call it what it is, anger at the rise of the encampments?
No, I think I would characterize it as frustration. I think Mar Vista is a liberal community, and everyone has compassion and empathy and wants to do the right thing. So everyone's, mm-hmm. got similarly minded when it comes to that. But the problem is I think people were just frustrated with the lack of any progress as to how to deal with it. I mean, we want to do the right thing, but nothing's happening. They're not being housed. It's not being contained. And they're encroaching on public property, which is basically a park that's being utilized by families, by soccer, you know, by sports-minded people, by people with dogs and other pets, as well as people that are just walking through there and exercising, because there's an exercise section to the park as well. Mm-hmm. So what I found is just people were just frustrated with the lack of seeing any progress. And, you know, and the way I look at it is, you know, one of my mentors told me a long time ago that perception is reality. And I think that was the problem, the perception that people were seeing, which they interpreted as reality and actually is reality, is nothing's being done. And I think the other issue that came into play is that when the optics were bad in regard to the Venice Boardwalk situation with the encampment there, it seems like Councilmember Bonin and the city council and whoever else was part of that moved quickly, you know, like turned on a dime, and all of a sudden within a couple of months, that boardwalk's clear. And I just saw a video this morning, I think on Nextdoor, of someone riding their, or maybe Twitter, someone riding their bicycle through the boardwalk area, and it was completely clear. So the lesson to me is not necessarily the grandstanding that was done by our sheriff or other people, but the fact that when the optics demanded it and there was some political consequences, the city and the agencies that are involved were able to step up and in a matter of months clear out that area. And so I feel that that should be done with Mar Vista Park as well.